ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة حتى تركها على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله تبارك وتعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Verily, all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His aid. We ask refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guide, none can lead astray. And whomsoever went astray, none can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His slave and messenger. O you who believe in Allah, fear Allah in the way who should be feared, and I not accept in the state of Islam with full and complete submission to Allah. O you mankind, be deedful to Allah, who created you from a single person, that is Adam alayhi salam. And from him he created his wife, and from both of them he created many men and many women. Be deedful to Allah, from whom you demand your mutual rights. Keep tight the relationship with your relatives, especially the kinship. Verily Allah is ever watcher upon you. O you who believe in Allah, fear Allah and say the truth. He will rectify your deeds and He will forgive your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger will achieve a great achievement. The best of the speech is the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the best of guidance is the guidance of our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of actions are the newly invented matters in Islam, where every newly invented matter in Islam is innovation, and every innovation is misguidance, and every misguidance will lead to the hellfire. My brothers and sisters in Islam, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in a hadith, أَحَبُّ الْبِلَادِ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَسَاجِدَهَا. He said alayhi salatu wa sallam, the most dear places in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal are the mosques, are the masajid, the houses of Allah Azza wa Jal. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah create whatever He wished, tabaraka wa ta'ala, and He choose from His creation. He created the creation and choose the mankind. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He created the mankind and choose the prophets and messengers alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And Allah Azza wa Jal created all lands. And Allah Azza wa Jal chose the masajid, the houses of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal, from those masajid, Allah chose the three masajid, al-masjid al-haram, wa-masjid al-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa-al-masjid al-aqsa. Those are the best masajid. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us in a hadith, لا تشد الرحال إلا إلى ثلاثة مساجد. That to travel for the sake to attend a masjid, specifically for the blessing of that masjid, then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you cannot do it for any masjid. There is no different blessings between any masajid. All the masajid are equal in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal, except the three masajid. إلا لثلاثة مساجد. Except for three mosques. And one of them is al-Masjid al-Haram. And one Masjid al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Masjid al-Aqsa. And as well, even in some saying of the scholars, which is even those minority, and yet, according to the hadith of Hudhayfa ibn Yaman, radiyallahu anhu, he said, even the i'tikaf is only held in the three masajid. So this is the status of these three masajid in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal. And as well that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is a hadith that narrated by Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, he said, سَأَلْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ عَنِ الصَّلَاةِ فِي بَيْتِ الْمَقْدِسِ أَفْضَلُ. He said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, asking, he said radiallahu anhu, asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is praying in the Masjid al-Aqsa better? أو الصلاة في مسجد رسول الله, or to pray in the Masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فقال, في مسجدي هذا أفضل من أربع صلوات فيه. He said to pray in the Masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is better than to pray in the Masjid al-Aqsa with four times. And we know to pray one single prayer in the Masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is equivalent to 1,000 prayer in any masjid elsewhere. And that means praying in al-Masjid al-Aqsa is equivalent to 250 prayers in any other masajid. And then he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, to continuing, وَلَنَعْمَ الْمُصَلَّى فِي أَرْضِ الْمَحْشَرِ وَالْمَنْشَرِ. He said, it is the best place to pray. It is the land of resurrection. The land of resurrection. The land of al-Aqsa and al-Sham. And he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, وَلَيَأْتِيَنَّ عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانٌ وَلَقَيْتُ صَوْطِي أَوْ قَالَ قَوْسُ الرَّجُلِ حَيْثُ يُرَى مِنْهُ بَيْتُ الْمَقْدِسِ خَيْرٌ لَهُ أَوْ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا جَمِيعًا. And he said عليه الصلاة والسلام, there will be a time that what is the bow will be when you put the bow on the ground. That ground. He said there will be a time that only piece of land which is only underneath a bow, he said, this is before the day of judgment, he said, it will be more dear and more beloved to the person that a land which is under a bow, that he could see al-Masjid al-Aqsa from distance. It is better than the everything in the world in the sight of its owner. So he said alayhi salatu wasalam, there will be a time that the people will be just only holding one spot, a spot which is a spot on land or a spot on the ground. That spot he could see or she could see al-Masjid al-Aqsa from that spot. And it is more dear to the person than what is in this all in this universe. SubhanAllah. What's the meaning of that? Wallahi, we are living in this time. And wallahi, there are lands. And I'm from Jordan. And there are some places people, they will not see it, because they can see al-Masjid al-Aqsa from one of the mountains in one clear night, just to see al-Masjid al-Aqsa from distance. And it is the time where al-Masjid al-Aqsa is away from the people, and al-Masjid al-Aqsa is taken from the Muslims. And subhanAllah, all of this weakness, we should understand that this weakness, because of the lack of our iman, my brothers and sisters. And he said alayhi salatu wasalam, as will many other hadith, talking about al-Masjid al-Aqsa and the importance of al-Masjid al-Aqsa. And as if we need to understand, al-Masjid al-Aqsa is a sign of the belief of the Ummah. The sign of the belief of the Ummah. Since Allah Azza wa Jal sent Ibrahim alayhi salam until he sent Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, that is a sign. Masjid al-Aqsa, it's a sign for the belief of the Ummah. When the Ummah, they have the perfect belief. Or at least they try to be as perfect as they can in terms of their belief. Then Allah Azza wa Jal will give them al-Masjid al-Aqsa on a golden plate. Like how it happened to Umar al-Khattab when he went alone and took the keys of al-Masjid al-Aqsa without even a single fight. And that's what happens. And when the Ummah iman declining and decreasing, then it is taken from them. And if you check the history, since the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam until our time, we will understand the situation. And Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded the children of Israel alayhi salam, the children of Yaqub alayhi salam. And it is a big mistake that we call this Zionist country to be Israel. The Israel alayhi wa ala nabiyyina salatu wassalam is an honorable name for Sayyiduna Yaqub alayhi wa ala nabiyyina salatu wassalam. It is a name of Yaqub. Allah has named him Israel, alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah named him this. Allah gave him that title. Subhanallah. So Allah Azza wa Jal has honored Yaqub alayhi salam with this name and this title. Regardless what those people are taking advantage of that title unlawfully. Wal-iyadu billah. So Allah Azza wa Jal has promised them that land and told them to enter al-masjid. Just only to enter the land which Allah has promised. They just only need to come in and to prostrate to Allah Azza wa Jal and to say hiqqa. It is as simple as that. And then they said to Musa alayhi wa nabiyyina as-salatu was-salam, go with your Lord and fight. We're going to sit here. And Allah Azza wa Jal, because of this action, Allah prevented them to enter the land that they are promised for 40 years. Why? Because of the lack of iman that they have. When the generation changed, after 40 years, when the iman of the believers at that time increased, Allah Azza wa Jal gave it to them back. And this is the situation of the belief of the ummah. So that's why, my brothers, Allah Azza wa Jal has honored that land. And Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned it in the Quran. Where Allah Azza wa Jal stated in the Quran, سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلَهِ. Glorify Allah Azza wa Jal. Glorify be to Allah Azza wa Jal, the one who made the night journey for his slave Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the night from the Masjid al-Haram, from the sacred house, to al-Masjid al-Aqsa, alladhi barakna hawla, the one which we surrounded it with a blessing. Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed that masjid. And Allah Azza wa Jal has surrounded it with a land of a blessing. And Allah Azza wa Jal has honored that masjid. And as well, that we need to understand that al-Masjid al-Aqsa, that it was built after al-Masjid al-Haram, were narrated by Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu. He said, قلت يا رسول الله أي مسجد وضع في الأرض أول. Which masjid was built first? Then he said عليه الصلاة والسلام المسجد الحرام, the sacred house. قلت ثم أي. Then I said, then what? Which masjid? And then he said عليه الصلاة والسلام المسجد الأقصى. قلت كم بينهما. What is the difference in time between them? He said عليه الصلاة والسلام 40 sana, 40 years between them. And narrated by Abu Umama radiyallahu anhu, even though this hadith has issues in terms of chain of narrations, but he said, nevertheless, we need to understand it under its context. He said, alayhi salatu wassalam, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي على الحق ظاهرين لعدوهم قاهرين لا يضرهم من خالفهم إلا من أصابهم من لأواء حتى يأتيهم أمر الله وهم كذلك. قالوا يا رسول الله وأين هم؟ قال ببيت المقدس وأكناف بيت المقدس. He said عليه الصلاة والسلام, they're gonna be part of my ummah, they're gonna be upon the truth, defeating their enemies, and they will be not harmed, and they will be not as well let down by those ones, but they're going to be let down until Allah Azza wa Jal bring His commandments to them. And even by their opponents, they will be not harmed and they will be not let down by their opponents. And whatever harms that it happens, they're going to be on this status until the commandments of Allah Azza will come to them. And then the Sahaba, they said, which one's Messenger of Allah? He said, those are the people in Bayt al-Maqdis and the people in the surrounding area in Bayt al-Maqdis. And the meaning of that, which is the Masjid al-Aqsa and the surrounding area of al-Masjid al-Aqsa. Even though that hadith, it is da'if according to the scholars of hadith. But yet, the meaning of it is correct. And the meaning of it, that the people who are going to be upon the truth, Allah Azza wa Jalla will give them the success. And as well, and it means there is a barakah and a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jalla in that land. And as well, we have many hadith talking about this. And look at the beautiful understanding of the scholars of Islam, like Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he said, بَدَى الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ مِنْ مَكَّةَ الْمُكَرَّمَةِ. That Allah Azza wa Jalla started the creation, and He created Mecca first. وَجَعَلَ بَيْتَ الْمَقْدِسِ وَمَا حَوْلَهُ مَحْشَرَ خَلْقِهِ. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has made a Bayt al-Maqdis and the surrounding area of a Bayt al-Maqdis as the land of resurrection. So it starts from Mecca. And at the end time, The beginning of the creation starts from Mecca. And the end time people will be resurrected in the land of Bayt al-Maqdis and the land which is around Bayt al-Maqdis. And then he said, فَإِلَى بَيْتُ الْمَقْدِسِ فَإِلَى بَيْتِ الْمَقْدِسِ يَعُودُ جَمِيعُ الْخَلْقِ. So to Bayt al-Maqdis, to Al-Aqsa, that all the creation will be returned back and they're going to be resurrected there. And that's why in the hadith to the Prophet ﷺ, he said, it is the land of al-mahshar wal-manshar. It is a land of the resurrection, and the people will be resurrected in that land. And then he continued, فَهُوَ الْبَيْتُ الَّذِي عَظَّمَتْهُ الْمِلَلُ. So it was honored, this land. It was honored by all the prophets and messengers of Allah. وَأَكْرَمَتْهُ الرُّسُلُ. And even the followers of the prophets, and the prophets of Allah and the messengers of Allah, they honored بيت المقدس. وَتُلِيَتْ فِيهِ الْكُتُبُ الْأَرْبَعَ. And in بيت المقدس, the four books were recited there. The four books which Allah has revealed, it was recited there. At-Tawrah, wal-Zabur, wal-Injil, wal-Qur'an. All of them, they were recited in Al-Bayt al-Maqdis, subhanAllah. That shows the significance of Al-Masjid al-Aqsa in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And that's why we need to understand when Umar al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu, when he put this, the wall around the Bayt al-Maqdis, all of it, this is Bayt al-Maqdis. And this is the place where the people have to, where Allah Azul has honored. And this is the place where Allah Azul has sent, made the right journey for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And not just that, it is the place, as in Masjid al-Aqsa, it was the first Qibla for the Muslimin. As we know that narrated in many hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to pray towards Bayt al-Maqdis. And this is after Allah Azza wa Jalla has made the night journey for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from year 9 of Ba'tha. After the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent, all the way until 3 years after migration of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they continued praying towards Bayt al-Maqdis. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla has changed the direction for the believers from Bayt al-Maqdis to Bayt al-Haram, Bayt Allah al-Haram, the sacred house of Allah Azza wa Jalla. That shows the significance of this land in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah Azza wa Jalla has sent the Prophet and messengers alayhim as-salatu wa salam to that land. Subhanallah. It's a land of blessing. It's a land that Allah has blessed. Allah musta'an. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوج المستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah عز وجل sent Ibrahim and Lut alayhima wa ala nabiyyina as-salatu was-salam. And this is before even Yaqub alayhi wa ala nabiyyina as-salatu was-salam. As Allah mentioned in the Quran, wa najaynahu wa Lut, Allah Azul has saved Ibrahim and Lut alayhi wa ala nabiyyina as-salatu was-salam ila al-ard allati barakna fiha, to the land that we blessed, allati barakna fiha lil-alamin, to the land that we blessed for the world, subhanallah. And that's why then Allah Azul has owned the children of Yaqub alayhi salam. And the believers, who are the followers of the believers, Allah Azza wa Jalla has honored them, those believers, honored them to take over and to come to the land that Allah Azza wa Jalla has promised. And as long as they continue in belief. So the point is, it's not about the race. It's about the belief in Allah Azza wa Jalla. It is for the believers. It is for those ones who follow the prophets of Allah alayhim wa ala nabiyyina salatu wa salam. It is for those ones who implement Tawheed. It is for those ones who worship Allah alone with no partners. It is for those ones who follow truly the prophets and messengers of Allah alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزَّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الذِّكْرِ أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِثُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ. That Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned in the Quran, in the Zabur, that this land, it will be inherited for my devoted servants. For those ones, the pious people, the followers of the Prophet and messengers of Allah, alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, This is the meaning of al-Bayt al-Maqdis's significance in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal. And subhanAllah, the weakness of our iman, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يُوشُكُ الْأُمَمُ أَن تَدَاعَ عَلَيْكُمْ كَمَا تَدَاعَ الْأَكَلَةُ عَلَىٰ قَصْعَتِهَا. He said, alayhi salatu wasalam, that the old nation will be attacking you like predators on one prey. And then one person said, O Messenger of Allah, are we little? Are we few at that time? He said, no, you're going to be a lot. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ غُثَاءٌ كَغُثَاءَ السَّيْلِ. You're going to be like the foam of the sea, the foam of the river. You are insignificant in the sight of the people. وَلَيَنْزِعَنَّ اللَّهُ مِنْ صُدُورِ عَدُوِّكُمُ الْمَهَابَةَ مِنْكُمْ. And Allah Azza wa Jal will take that even, will take that the fear, or have any fear from the heart of your enemy from you. They will be not afraid from you, subhanAllah. وَلَيَكْذِفَنَّ اللَّهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمُ الْوَهَمْ. And then Allah Azza wa Jal will place in your heart wahan. And then they said, what is wahan, Messenger of Allah? What is the meaning of this? He said, حُبُّ الدُّنْيَا وَكْرَاهِيَةُ الْمَوْتِ. You're going to be loved the dunya, and you're going to hate death. And this is exactly what we are facing nowadays. We love dunya. We love our money. We love our houses. We love our shops. We love our business. SubhanAllah. And as if we're going to live here for eternity. And we hate death. We don't remember akhirah. We don't remember Allah Azza wa Jalla except little. And that's exactly what's happening to us, my brothers and sisters. And that's why, my brothers and sisters, many of the scholars of Islam, they said, if you are able to visit Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, then try your best to visit it. And try your best to visit it before a time comes that you will be prevented even to see it from distance. And that's why, according to the hadith, there's going to be even one single spot on the ground just to see Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa from distance. It's going to be worth whatever in the world from the wealth. Just only a spot that we could see Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa from distance. And subhanAllah, and even that spot might be taken from us. So that's why try your best, inshallah, to visit Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa as soon as you can. And try to attend there and pray there. And as we make dua that Allah Azza wa Jal to return it back in the hands of the believers, to return it back to the muwahideen, to those who follows Allah and the Messenger alayhi as-salatu was-salam, and Allah Azza wa Jal to bring unity between Muslims. As the ayah said, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold them upon the rope of Allah Azza wa Jal, and do not disassociate with each other. Stay together. Have unity between amongst you. And then Allah Azza wa Jal, and this unity, it has to be according to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah Azza wa Jal will bring the success. عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة القدس فقال جل من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأجل وأتم وأكبر. وأقم الصلاة. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.